What constitutes the Haram Mosque of Mecca? This is from Raji Mortella. What area actually constitutes the Haram Mosque of Mecca? In other words, where are the boundaries where a Muslim should pray in order to get their word mentioned by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? And let me broaden the answer to cover Al-Madinah as well. As far as the word Haram, it means sanctuary. Sanctuary, once you enter from any of its borders, then you are in a sanctuary. You cannot do certain things. You cannot even think of bad thoughts, because thinking of bad thoughts within the boundaries of the Haram is a sin, even if you do not do it. And in Mecca, some of the scholars say the word of praying anywhere in Mecca is haram. It's similar to Al-Masjid al-Haram. Of course, it is greater to pray around the Kaaba or inside Al-Masjid al-Haram. But the reward of 100,000 times more than praying anywhere else counts anywhere inside the haram, in the hotel room, in any neighborhood in Mecca. The boundaries of Mecca, which have green markers now and so on, are set by Jibreel alayhi salam, who indicated them and pointed Ibrahim alayhi salam to know them when Ibrahim and Ismail finished the construction of the Kaaba. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam maintained them as well. There is a hadith in which the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said that Ibrahim alayhi salam prayed and asked Allah to make Mecca sanctuary, and Allah answered, رَبِّ جَعَلْ هَذَا بَلَدًا آمِنًا. Ibrahim alayhi salam said, oh Allah, make this is a sacred and a safe city, a sanctuary. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted his dua, and Ibrahim alayhi salam was informed. And these places, for instance, from up north, if you're coming from the direction of Medina towards Mecca, the sanctuary begins at a place called At-Tan'im. This is where there is a masjid now, is known as Masjid Aisha. This is the closest point of the hill to the haram. The closest point of the hill to the sanctuary of Mecca, to Al-Masjid al-Haram, because it's approximately only 3 miles. That's why people take a cab or a microbus back and forth, 15 minutes, 15 riyal, in order to make an intention for Umrah and come back. Why is it called Masjid Aisha? This is because when Aisha, may Allah be pleased with her, performed Hajj with the Prophet ﷺ, and she had her menses, after she finished the Hajj, she felt sorry and she wanted to perform Umrah too. So the Prophet ﷺ sent her brother with her, Abdul Rahman ibn Abi Bakr, to the hill, outside the sanctuary. The closest point was at Tan'im. This is from the direction of the north coming from Al-Madinah. So whether it's called Tan'im or Masjid Aisha. From the direction of Jeddah, it's a place which was known as Al-Hudaybiyah. There was a masjid, Masjid al-Shajara. This is where the treaty of Al-Hudaybiyah took place. And there is a very interesting fact about it, that it's about 10 miles outside the Haram. 10 miles from the Haram. That the Prophet ﷺ, when he and the 1400 of his companions camped outside the Haram in Al-Hudaybiyah, waiting for the permission of the Meccans to enter to perform the Umrah, that was in the 6th year after the migration, the Prophet ﷺ, whenever it was a prayer time, he used to walk towards the Haram a few steps so that he will be praying within the Haram boundaries. There are other boundaries, of course, and markers, but the names are not familiar to most of you, such as from the direction of At-Ta'if, it's called Urana or Namira, because Masjid Namira itself, a part of it constitutes the Haram, and a part of it is outside the Haram. That's why you see a line in the front, where if you are a Haji, you do not sit in the front rows, because this is considered outside the Haram area, and so on. What about Al-Madinah? The rest of the hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, and I too prayed and asked Allah to make Al-Madinah a sanctuary, and he accepted my dua. But what constitutes the haram which earns a reward of 1,000 times better or more than praying anywhere else in Medina is only within Al-Masjid al-Nabawi. In the haram, we're not allowed to break a tree or kill a bird or frighten a bird or anything that's not harmful.